welcome to our new game. Find the rule, where each abstract header must find its own rule. Previously on Find the Rule, our plucky protagonist, the CoAP header, faced a series of heartbreaking disappointments in its quest for the perfect match. Rule 1/8 left our hero feeling incomplete, failing to cover all the bases. Rule 2/8 came on too strong, bringing extra baggage to the relationship. Just when all seemed lost, Rule 3/8 appeared, a seeming soulmate with all the right fields. But alas, in a cruel twist of fate, the key call operator played the villain, crushing our hopes at the last second. But wait, what's this? A new challenger approaches. Tonight on an all-new episode, Rule 4/8 enters the scene. Is this the one our CoAP header has been waiting for? What makes this rule different, and why is everyone suddenly so optimistic? Tune in to find out if we'll finally get our happily ever after in the wild world of network protocols.
Hi there, I'm Rule 4/8, and I'm here to win your hearts and, more importantly, to match your CoAP header. You might remember my cousin, Rule 3/8. We're practically twins. I've got all the same field descriptions that made you fall for 3/8, but here's where I shine that tricky last field. My target value is a cool 60, just like your CoAP header dreams about at night. I'm not just a good match, folks. I'm the perfect match you've been searching for all along. So what do you say? Ready to end this season with a happily ever after?
Welcome to Find the Rules. The crowd is on their feet, the judges are on the edge of their seats, and we're all eager to see if you can go all the way. The contestant has made a perfect match. His answers align in both in field, ID and values. As a result, we're skipping ahead to the final round. Are you ready to make header compression history tonight? Alright folks, we've just unlocked the final piece of the puzzle in Rule 4/8. This last column is all about compression decompression actions, or CDAs for those in the know. It tells us how to shrink our value for the journey and then magically expand it back at the finish line. Now, let's take a closer look at the heavy hitters in this CDA lineup. When you see the not sent CDA, it's like a secret shortcut. This sneaky little action is telling us, hey, don't bother sending this field. It's already hanging out in the rule. It's like having a cheat code that saves us time and effort. Pretty clever, right? This not sense trick is nothing short of wizardry. We can wave our magic wand over version, type, token length, and even code. It's like a supernatural disappearing act. Abracadabra, two whole bytes of fields vanish into thin air during transmission. Step right up, viewers, as we enter the mystical realm of LSB. That's at least significant bits for the uninitiated. This crafty little trick tells us to focus on just the rightmost bits of our field value. But here's the million-dollar question. How many of these bits are we talking about? Well, folks, the answer is hiding in plain sight. Our rule says, the field is a sweet 16 bits long, and the MSB argument is waving the number 8 at us. So, put on your thinking caps. If we subtract 8 from 16, what do we get? That's right, a number of 8 bits to send. It's like a puzzle within a puzzle. Isn't data compression just full of surprises? We're about to do a complete 180 with a value sent. This is the total opposite of our not sent CDA, folks. Here, we're beaming out every single bit of those fields. But the million-dollar question is, how many bits are we dealing with? Now, you might think this is a no-brainer. Just check the field length, right? But hold your horses. What's this? Instead of a number, we've got a mysterious code. TKL. Don't touch that dial, dear viewers. This enigmatic TL8 isn't just alphabet soup. It's our secret decoder. It's pointing us to a hidden treasure in the TKLE field. And what do we uncover there? A whopping 2 bytes, or for those keeping score at home, 16 bits. Hold on to your hats, folks. We've got another CDA coming at you, and this one's a real mind-bender. Say hello to a mapping sense. Instead of sending the whole enchilada, we're dishing out a bite-sized index. But here's the kicker. How big is this index? Well, it's just as big as it needs to be to get the job done. And get this, in our example, we're working some serious magic here. We're taking those long, winding chains of characters and presto, squeezing them down to a single bit. That's right, one tiny bit doing the heavy lifting of an entire string. Well, 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 look who's back. Folks, our old friend Value Sense. But hold on to your hats, because there's a twist in this tale. This time, the rule isn't giving us the length on a silver platter. Oh no, we've got something far more intriguing, the var function. Sharp-eyed viewers, I hope you spotted that little gem from the start. Now, what's this if all business all about? It's like we've stumbled into Aladdin's cave of wonders. The possibilities are endless. But don't worry, we're not flying blind. Before we unveil the value itself, we're getting a sneak peek at its length. And for our grand finale, folks, give it up for the NotSense CDA. It's not sending the value at all, because it's already there in the target value.
Now that I've clinched the win, let's ditch the theory and dive into action. I'm thrilled to compress my beloved co-op header. Here's how it'll go down. We kick off with 8 bits for my rule ID. Then, surprise, the last 8 bits of the message ID. Next up, 16 bits of token goodness. Oh, and don't forget that tiny 1 bit for the mapping send index. It's one cause we're going with the second element name status. Now for the second URI path, we've got door. But hold your horses. The var function's making us send the length first. That's 4 characters coded on 4 bits. Then we spell out D-O-O-R. And boom, we're done. Again, grand total. 69 bits, folks. But here's the kicker, that 1-bit mapping index and 4-bit variable length threw our alignment for a loop. So we're tossing in 3 bits of padding to hit that byte boundary. The final score? My gorgeous CoAP header, now a svelte 9 bytes. How's that for a compression slam dunk?
69 bits total, a sprinkle of padding, and bingo, 9 bytes of compressed header magic. But hold on to your remotes. Viewers, we've got to dash to a quick break. Don't go anywhere. This bite-sized drama is just heating up.